set up too high. Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar, and I have Amber Lee with me tonight as my guest and ladies' night. And we're recording this a little bit early. Both of us have some things going on tonight, so we're going to work on this so that we can present to you a wonderful ladies' night. And I asked Amber to especially come on because she's doing a lot of really cool things with her son. And I know a lot of the people in our audience are mothers or possibly fathers. I don't know. We've got men in the group, I know, also. But there are a lot of things that she does that I really think are cool. And I think we'll start out with that and talk a little bit about Tim, Amber, and some of the things you're doing with him, you know, that are kind of different than what the average school and all that does.
Okay. Thank you, Lynda. I appreciate that. And we appreciate you, you know, getting inspired by what we're doing. So let me just tell a little bit of my backstory. You know, about 6 years ago, I had Timothy when I was 18, and from about 18 to 24, I was addicted to drugs. So I don't want people to look at me like I'm just this perfect mother. That there was a lot of processes that got to that. And about 6 years ago, I got sober, and I got introduced to the law of attraction. And through that, I started teaching Timothy some principles because I noticed that at 5 years old, he had picked up some really bad habits. Screaming, the way that we spoke. You know, something that I read is that most kids hear the word no 40,000 times before they're 5 years old. And it's how we speak and communicate to each other in our society. We always talk about what we don't want. That's how we communicate. We communicate what we don't want instead of what we do want. And we do that early on with our kids. Don't touch that. Stop. No. Don't do that. No. 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 You know, that's what we say instead of saying, let's keep our hands to ourselves or come over here or let's do this or yes, at a later date, you will be able to do that. You know, we always communicate by saying no. And so I noticed that and I wanted to break the pattern. And so I started teaching him things that I was learning that were in line with the law of attraction. And we both started listening to Napoleon Hill, Think and Grow Rich. And so now, at 11 years old, Timothy has started his own t-shirt business.
Awesome.
And he also does motivational videos online. And, you know, his last few t-shirts have been kind of around, one was Nerd is the New Cool, and the other one was Get Your Nerd On. Sorry. The other one was Get Your Nerd On. And, you know, his idea behind that, what he wanted to do is, I guess he just felt like nerd was kind of like that word that most people will call other people that aren't normal to them, I guess. And so he wanted to inspire people to be yourself, you know, no matter who you are, adult,
right.
Children, you know.
And it's cool to be nerd, right?
It's cool to be nerd. It's cool to be yourself, like be who you are. Right. You know, Timothy has been called that a lot of times growing up. And like I used to tell him, kids just don't understand what you're talking about because they're not taught that. And so when something's different, they have to put a label on it. But it's okay. Own your nerd. You are nerdy. I'm nerdy. It's okay. It's good.
We all are.
Yeah, so.
Entrepreneurial people.
Exactly. So he owned it, and now he's making money off of it. So I think it's great. So that is his story. Awesome. I wish he was here, but he is at a neighbor's house playing, so.
That's all right. Yeah, we see all your pictures with him, and you have an incredible relationship with him, especially starting into his teen years. So it's pretty cool.
Yes, I think that's, you know, a lot of people, they think that being a single mom is a less fortunate type thing, and I actually think that that's the beauty of being a single mom is that I can have that relationship with him and that bond. I feel like you need something a little bit closer with kids who only have one parent in the household.
Because you have to be both.
Yes. And not just that, but you're the only one that they're looking at. There isn't another example. You're it. You're the example. And so whatever you're doing, they're going to do. And I'm an example of that, because when I was doing the negative things, he was emulating that. And now that I'm doing something positive, he's just responding to that. So kids respond to what's in the household.
Oh, for sure. And tell me more about his T-shirt business.
So he uses Teespring, and Timothy is a very good drawer. So he draws all of his designs and comes up with them on his own. His first shirt was Nerd is the New Cool. And he actually didn't make a whole lot, but he made $28 on his first campaign. And so
okay, we've lost you. Yeah, there you.
Yeah, so he used a little bit of that money, and he invested in getting a graphic designer to kind of help him shape his design. And then I actually took some of that money, put some money with it, and we're starting to do some paid advertising on Facebook.
Nice.
So trying to teach him.
Yeah, we have a program right there in the PLS. Are you training him from that?
Yes, I train him from what I know, and yeah, a lot of what I know is from that Facebook training within the PLS. So yes, we use that, and he actually is setting up his own list as well.
Nice. Yeah, wow. So. Well, you think about this now. He's 11 years old, and he's already learning some really amazing skills as a business owner and an online marketer that most kids don't even have a clue about. And kids are so much more adaptable to this online world anyway. I mean, they were born into it. And so it's no big deal for them to do it. Okay, Amber, are you still there?
Yes.
Okay.
He definitely gets it. And it's funny because he talks to his friends about it, and they don't understand it. And so when they come over here, he shows them. You know, he shows them. Yeah. His shirts, and he shows him his Facebook page, his fan page, and all that good stuff.
Be a little celebrity.
Yes. And he's teaching them things that they don't know or that they're not taught within the household. So, and that's what he likes to do in his videos. He's getting better at them. We've actually got some videos that we've made, and he's having some people edit them for him. So,
cool.
He's getting better and better.
Now, does he use any of your products, your online products?
He does use the PLS. He's actually using my system right now. I will probably buy him his own separate account. But he does use it. He has a buyer's list of who has bought from him. And then he also has a list just to get on. Because what I'm trying to teach him is when someone buys from you once, they'll probably buy from you again if you continue to build that relationship. Right. And then, two, when you get new shirts, instead of having to call these people up individually, you can just send out a blast email and let them know, hey, I released a new shirt, or I released a new video, or whatever it is that he's doing.
Yeah, absolutely. So is he blogging also?
He is not blogging yet. We are getting there. He is getting the videos down. Kids are they are like sponges, and he soaks it all up, but I don't want to overwhelm him as well. So right now, he does write out his videos, and so I'm teaching him how to repurpose those to where he can write those into blogs.
Oh, yeah, easily.
Yes.
I mean, that would be so simple. He can start out with a free blog. There's plenty of places where he can do that.
Yeah, with Tumblr.
Go from there, yeah.
Yes, yeah, and we're getting all that together as far as his business plan, having him write things out just so that he understands every aspect of it.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So how do you work around that now? You're probably sharing the same computer with your son. So
actually,
in a way, you're doing a little bit of competition.
Actually, he has his own computer.
Oh, good.
Yeah, he has his own Chromebook, and he uses that. And a lot of the things, like when we sit down and write content, we sit at the table and write it out first. So we do a lot of that together, and really just so that I could teach him the process that I go through.
Nice. That's pretty cool. I mean, I do admire any parent actually teaches their children money skills and actual, business processes like you're doing, because when you don't do that, I mean, I didn't know to do that when I was a young parent, but with kids now, I mean, they're really wanting to do that, and their chances of just going to college job are so poor that, you know, they've really got to have, you know, some other plan, and if they've got skills like this, they don't have to ever worry.
Right. Yes. And that's that is the big point. I've had people ask me, am I making him be an entrepreneur? And Timothy is allowed to be whatever he wants. He wants to go to college because he wants to play college football. Sure. And I encourage him to do that. I think Timothy, I teach him that he is allowed to be whatever and whoever he wants to be. But I teach him these skills early on because, as you said, you know, going to college and getting a job, 40%, probably more than that, like 60% of people don't even use the degree that they paid for.
I know, I didn't.
Right. And so, you know, I want him to be able to fall back on things. And also, you know, going through their teen years, you know, I am a single mom. Thank God that I did find online marketing and I get to work from home. But a lot of our parents, you know, we're out of the home a lot as single parents.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So kids get mixed up. And I want him to know how to create money early on so that when he is approached with those things, he can say, I don't need that. I already make money, you know, legally. Yeah. And I know how to create money and I can show you. So not just really just for him, but also so that other kids can be a byproduct of who he is as well.
You know, right.
So he can teach others.
Well, he can get to a place where he's training his friends to do stuff. Sounds like he's almost doing that already.
Yes, and that is his ultimate goal. Here he is now. That is one of his big goals, is to be able to do that. Say hi.
Hey, Tim.
So, but yeah, and that's one of his big goals, is to be able, I want to build an entrepreneur for kids and teach them the law of attraction, and he wants to be able to teach with me. So. Can you see? There he is. He just got out from playing outside.
No, from playing at a friend's.
Oh, okay, at a friend's house.
Or talking about you, or your ears burning.
I know, we were talking about you and your business and stuff, so. Crazy kids. Yeah, so that's our ultimate goal, is to be able to build that.
So what kind of, you know, if somebody wanted to start doing that and they haven't done what you've been doing, what would you give them as some advice to, you know, get started with that?
I would say the first thing for online marketing and marketing is to find yourself a mentor. You know, it's always good to have someone teaching you that has already been through it themselves. And so I would say the first step is to find a mentor. You know, there's a lot of us that have been doing it, and then that can teach you the basics. And second, I would say always start by building your list. That was one of the first things that I taught Timothy to do. And building your list is really important, because you're building a relationship with people and you're building a list of buyers that you can go to. So I would say start there and find a mentor.
Yeah, and with kids being marketers or entrepreneurs online, what kinds of things could they start? I mean, I know Timothy's doing T-shirts, but are there other things that would be good for them to start that is easy for kids to do?
Oh, yeah, like YouTube, I think, is an amazing place for kids to show off their talent. I don't know if y'all have ever heard of, there's a kid called Kid President. And me and Timothy watch him all the time. He's amazing. And he does motivational videos like Timothy. But I think videos is a really good place to start. Mm-hmm. And to kind of, I mean, it doesn't matter what talent you have, you can put that on video and on YouTube. So I think that that's a great place to start. I think T-shirts are great because Teespring is very low overhead cost. It really costs nothing to get started. So I would say start there. And even kids like I have a niece of mine that likes to write. So even starting e-books and just kind of helping kids get their message out there. You know, we all have a message no matter how young or old we are.
Absolutely.
And we can all get around.
What kinds of things do they write?
Well, I mean, you can do really short ebooks, like 20-page ebooks. So she does poetry. So you could write poetry. You could write a short story. You could write an experience. I think it's really cool when I've seen some books where they kind of emulate. Did you hear me? Are you there, Lynda?
Yes, yes. I was just waiting to see if you were still.
I think it was, what were those books when I was younger? It was Chicken Soup for the Teenage Soul.
All right, yes.
And, you know, just kind of short stories like that. You know, kids are very creative these days.
Right. You just tap into whatever their creativity is.
That's how it came about with Timothy. I just started asking him what he wanted to do, and he was drawing stuff, and I was like, wouldn't that be really cool if someone wore your stuff on a t-shirt? And he just kind of took off with it.
Wow. That's pretty fun. Yeah. So, do you have any of his drawings people can see?
Do we have some of your drawings right now? I don't know if we have them right now, but I can post them.
Okay.
And I can tag you in them as well.
Sure. And, you know, if somebody wanted to actually get in touch with you so they could start their own child on something, would the Facebook page be the best place to find you?
Yes, they can go to facebook.com/AmberMichelleLee11, okay. And they can find me on Facebook. And just inbox me is the best way to get me. I'm very personable, so don't be scared.
Right.
Normal.
And both of us have the same businesses, so if Amber brought you here, then obviously click on her button and she'll be glad to share that with you. And if you came because you saw me posting it, then click on my green button.
And also, they can find Timothy at facebook.com/TimothyInspires.
It's nice.
His fan page.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So.
Yep, well, you know what? That is so much better than if he wanted to do, you know, like a rock star kind of a thing. I think it's very down to earth, and yet it's very creative and very cool.
Well, thank you. We owe that to Timothy because he came up with it. I'm just really proud of him, just for his videos too. You know, people always ask me, do I make him do the videos? And I don't. He does them on his own. I will be in the other room and I will hear him talking, and I'll be like, who are you talking to? And he'll be like, you're messing up my video.
Yeah.
So he just, you know, if you let kids be creative, I think that we put so much emphasis on wanting our kids to be obedient that we forget to let them be creative. You know, and
or pushing them into sports they don't like, or, you know.
Yeah, or we push them. Push them into being quiet and sit down and put your hands on your lap. You know, let them be creative. Let them let those juices flow. They will come up with some great ideas, some great things.
Absolutely. And, you know, I had Kimberly Olson as one of my other interviewees recently, and it's amazing some of the things that kids can do. And she's got four of her own, and she's doing that too, and
yes,
in a lot of ways.
Yes, she does an amazing job with her kids. I actually have been needing to reach out to her to kind of get her kids and Timothy connected. And that's another thing. If you have kids that are, you know, that are creative, and, you know, have them connect with Timothy and, you know, into the law of attraction, or want them to learn about it, you know, just like we like to meet like-minded people, Timothy loves to meet like-minded kids because there's not a lot of them that think like him.
Right. You don't want the negative kids that are really down on everything. And I bet his school grades are good because he's happy about what he's doing in his life.
Yeah, they are. He gets really, really, really good grades.
Awesome.
I will say that.
Well, I think it's been proven that when kids are doing something they like, when they find something that they feel good about, then they're good at everything else. I mean, not that they're perfect, but they don't fail at their classes because they have a better self-esteem.
Yes, yes. And you know, and that's the thing that I teach Timothy. I don't try to make him great at something that he's not good at. So if there's something that he struggles with in school, which he's pretty good with school, but if there's different things that he struggles at, I don't push him to be great at those. And that's kind of what I teach other people too, is if your kid is not an A student in math, it's okay.
Yeah.
You know, if he struggles to get a D, that's okay. Teach him the basics. just help him get through and learn what he needs to learn, but don't make him be a master in geography if he's not great at math, you know? I mean, a master at geometry. You know, like, don't force them to be an A student if they're not.
No, and the emphasis on that, that's all about college anyway, which doesn't mean a thing if you're, you know, it does in a sense if you're going to go for a certain college track. But if you have enough talent in something, like, for instance, he likes football, maybe he's going to be at a point where he can get a scholarship at a college for that.
Right. Yes.
Not a college, Kentucky.
Oh, he said Kentucky.
That's
going to be cool. Knows where he wants, yes, he does know where he wants to go and what he wants to do. But he actually has another talent, which is really funny. He's actually a very great commentator. He can commentate anything. So.
So he could do that track too.
Yes. Yes, he could.
You mean with the games?
Yeah, with any games. He's been doing that since he was 3 years old. He can commentate anything.
So he's watching it just on the TV, and he's telling you what's going on.
Yes, and he can tell you play by play, action by action. It's crazy. He's really good at it.
Yeah, having the eye to be able to pick up on that. I have the I can't follow football anyway, but if I even knew what was going on, I would be, you know. I can follow baseball, but not football.
Really? Yeah, we're big football fans over here. But and Timothy's good at football. So I always say he's going to be a commentator or a coach. He's very good with the game in his mind. So
that's cool.
Yeah.
Well, Amber, I was thinking we were going to talk about marketing, but then when we started to talk about Timothy and the things you're doing, I just felt like that was going to be the place where people would get the most out of our talk tonight. So is there any parting things that you'd like to share that you think would be really helpful to others?
You know, just encourage your kids, and if you're in the industry, most likely you've been introduced to the law of attraction, and you know what you're learning, teach it to your kids. I know a lot of us, I know in the beginning I felt like he wasn't going to understand it, but when I started listening to audios and he was around me, he would start repeating the things back. So kids watch you, they listen to you, they listen to what you're listening to. So, put it in your kids' life. They need it. Think about if you knew this 10 years ago, and where your life would be.
Right, you know? Different.
If you knew this, when you were younger, where your life would be. And so take that gift instead of being like, oh, I didn't know it, you know, and give that to your kids.
That is great, great advice. And even if you're not a beginner parent, I mean, you can always start wherever you are right now.
Yeah, your grandkids, teach your kids to teach their kids. You know, or wherever you're at, like, I teach my mom. You know, she doesn't know about this stuff, but I teach her, and in return, she teaches my nephews, and even when she's around Timothy, you know, the conversation is the same because we're all on the same path.
Absolutely. Yeah, there's no such thing as a dog can't learn new tricks. That's just one of those things that's absolutely not true.
No.
And we just, no matter what age you are, you can change.
Yes, very true. That's just a saying that sounded good, so it caught on.
It's an excuse to not change, to stay in a rut.
There you go.
So we can't say that one anymore, can we?
No, we cannot. Nope, definitely cannot.
Well, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up, and I really appreciate you coming on, Amber. I know that you're a busy mom with your child and with your business and the stuff going on, and I know you had a meeting coming up pretty soon, and I'm just going to wrap this up, and I so appreciate you coming on with us tonight and ladies' night.
Well, thank you for having me, Lynda. I appreciate it, and thanks for thinking enough about Timothy to want to talk about him and what he's doing. Really appreciate that.
Oh, yeah. All right.